Welcome back to New York and our New York studios and the road to the Final Four. Out in St. Louis, they're getting ready for the Missouri Valley Conference Championship game. Illinois State and Creighton, bubble teams across America are watching this game.
Yeah, you take a look there at Doug McDermott, who is probably going to be the player of the year potentially in the Missouri Valley. But how about the way that Illinois State played yesterday? Jackie Carmichael, their best player, but Tyler Brown drops 25 in the game. They only shot 34% from the field, but they go 20 of 22 at the free throw line.
And that's going to be an interesting dynamic in this game, because the one problem that Creighton has had this season is defense. They like to outscore people. They don't like to shut people down. The last time that they played, Brian Allen came off the bench to score 29 points. So Mr. Dougie is going to have to really go off today for them to win.
All right, let's go to the scoreboard. Michigan paying a visit to Penn State.
Michigan Wolverines, nobody is going to want to see this team in the NCAA tournament. They play such efficient, unique style of offensive basketball. That was Evan Smotrich nailing the three-pointer. They can all shoot. They can all defend. They can all pass, and they are all over Penn State.
In Madison, Wisconsin, the Badgers hosting Illinois.
On senior day, how about Rob Wilson, Jordan Taylor both being honored here, and then Ryan Evans gets it over to Jordan Taylor, who knocks down the three. And I tell you what, Wisconsin all over Illinois here early on. And then Rob Wilson again knocking down the three here. 14-2 at that point. Wisconsin rolling.
Badgers are on a roll. Meanwhile, in Tallahassee, Clemson and Florida State.
And Bernard James, he was ejected from the game against Virginia for a flagrant two. Comes back here finishing the dunk that put the Seminoles up by seven. Seminoles, I don't think they're quite as good as they are. They were last year when they made the Sweet 16. I don't think they can score it. Maybe not quite as dominant defensively without Chris Singleton. But this was a nice win at home today.
Under a half a minute to play in that game, and it's a tight one. That does it for us here. Coming up next, Missouri Valley Conference Championship matchup. We'll send you off to St. Louis after this. CBS Sports coverage of the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship is sponsored by Ram Trucks. Guts. Glory. Ram. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And by State Farm, for auto, home, life, and banking. Get to a better state.
Missouri. It's the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship game here on the road to the Final Four on CBS Sports. Here is the road these two teams have taken, Illinois State and Creighton. The shocker was that Wichita State went down to the Redbirds and to the Blue Jays. Held serve against Evansville. And here are the lineups on the floor. Moore, Brown, Wilkins, Ikey, and Carmichael, the one to watch for Illinois State. Creighton with Gibbs, Manigault, Young, Echenique, and the Larry Bird Award winner for outstanding player in this conference, Doug McDermott. Tim Jankovic played for Jack Hartman at Kansas State as coach for the likes of Boyd Grant, Bill Self, and Kevin Stallings. Now his fifth season in Normal, Illinois. And Greg McDermott, formerly of Iowa State, prior to that Northern Iowa, now just in his second season in relief of Dana Altman, who did such a magnificent job before heading to Oregon. Our officials, Scott Thornley, Michael Stewart, Kelly Self, Tim Brando, alongside Mike Jaminski, the G-Man, and we are underway in St. Louis, and we will crown a champion today and punch a ticket to the NCAA tournament.
Love doing tournament finals, Timmy. I mean, it's just a, you know, there's a lot at stake for both teams, but certainly for Illinois State, this is the way they get into the NCAA tournament to win.
And we both can't wait to see this young man live. McDermott using the window, not there, but there's the follow. Grant Gibbs, the junior from Marion, Iowa, a Gonzaga transfer, and it's 2-0 Creighton.
Really interesting stat line for him. 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 6 points on average. He does a lot of everything for this team.
Wilkins and Carmichael, a pair of bigs. One plays outside, the other inside. Could be very big today if Illinois State is to steal a bid into the NCAAs. That one doesn't fall for Carmichael.
They got the switch, and Carmichael really bailed out McDermott by taking a jump shot instead of forcing the action into the paint.
And Echenique got it quickly, was doubled inside. And got it back out to the perimeter.
Echenique is going to be a big key for them, Tim. When he's really aggressive in the low post, it opens things up for their perimeter.
Shaheen's Manigault with the clock under 10 decides to pump from downtown. Carmichael retrieves it for Illinois State.
He missed there, but this Creighton team, I think it's safe to say they're the best shooting team in the country. Their numbers are staggering.
Well, the Redbirds have been in this game 3 of the 5 years Jankovic has been there, and Tyler Brown, the junior transfer. transfer from Owensboro, Kentucky, drains the triple.
25 yesterday in that upset at Wichita State. And Tim Jenglish knows his team has not shot the ball well yet in this tournament. He's looking for a breakout game.
Team came from behind. They trailed by 9 at the intermission against Greg Marshall's Wichita State team, who's likely to grab not only a good bid, but a one that would probably have them on the 5 line as Echenique gets that one to go. Inside, it's now 4-3 Creighton.
They really do a nice job of using him in the screen roll and letting him work to the front of the rim.
Wilkins. He plays Drano from downtown. Jenton Wilkins. They call him Frenchie. No French pastry, though. That was just a really nice shot.
Well, his assignment is going to be guarding McDermott on the other end. In the two-game series in the regular season, he has played him man-to-man. They like his size and length on McDermott.
Nice drive to the rack by Gibbs, using the left hand.
Really, just an all-court game, does everything well, and also defends on the other end extremely well.
I know you love the efficiency of this Creighton offense. They are very effective on the offensive end of the floor. Already 6 points in the paints for them. As you see, Jankovic talking with Michael Stewart. Here's the profile of Illinois State. Their enrollment very solid, and Doug Collins has the court named after him. Yeah. One of our favorites.
I had a little text conversation with him this morning. He is fired up about his Redbirds.
And Jankovic told us he hears from him all the time. He calls Tim about as often as he does Chris Collins down in Durham, North Carolina. And best I can tell, and I've done as much research as I can, he may be the only former player to have a court named after him in the NCAAs. Most of the time, coaches, past legendary coaches, have the name of the court on the home floor.
He was a legendary player for sure in his time there and has gone on to be a great pro coach, doing a great job with the Sixers this year.
Carmichael trying to go reversal, can't get it. And Wilkins' putback doesn't work either.
Yeah, one of those easy ones that work is you have to convert that.
Echenique strong with the basket. And as he goes early, they go in your estimation.
Yeah, no, he needs to be aggressive. And also, you got two guys who are all defensive team in the Valley. And Carmichael, and they're going man-on-man out there down in the low post.
Creighton's 4 field goals all in the painted area. This will be a decidedly Creighton crowd. They bought more than 3,000 all-session tickets for this tournament, the most of any team, as that one doesn't fall for Nick Moore. Blue Jays by 2. 4 minutes gone by here in St. Louis. Strong move by Antoine Young and a foul underneath as he was making his move. A youngster from Venezuela by way of St. Benedict's and Rutgers with a royal flush in the month of March. Creighton has a 2-point lead, and G-Man, how about a little AT&T fast analysis on our game?
Well, you look at Tyler Brown for Illinois State, really carried them yesterday. He's had 5 20-point games on the year, 25 yesterday against Wichita State. Can attack the glass, likes to get out in the open floor, and also over 40% from 3. And then there's the All-American candidate, Doug McDermott, has an all-court game as well. He can stretch you, really fights hard on every possession to get touches down in the low post.
Yeah, you just won't believe it until we show it to you, how much he works off the ball to get free. And a lot of times, Mike, you know this, great offensive players know they're going to be fouled, and most of the time it won't be called. He never gets frustrated, does he?
No, and always has the same demeanor out on the floor. Although I will say this, I think John Wilkins is a good matchup defensively for Illinois State because of the length down inside. And you know, Evansville just had their hands full with him yesterday. They tried to clog the paint, and that's what a lot of teams do against McDermott, to limit his touches. But these, I think they right now early, Tim, they've really tried to get Echenique touches and get him off. A great scorer like McDermott is going to find his points.
Antoine Young, one of the homegrown Huskers that plays for this Blue Jays team. Bellevue, Nebraska, played at Bellevue Prep. And that town just so embraces their basketball. Young leaves the game after the free throw. and is replaced by Austin Chapman. And they lose nothing when the freshman comes onto the floor from Colony, Texas, just outside Houston.
I think right now, too, Creighton, because of their easy win against Evansville yesterday, is the fresher team that Greg McDermott able to rest his players, especially his starters, and that could be a factor in this game.
Well, that was Brown, just off your fast analysis, right on cue with the runner in the lane to make it a 9-8 game. With the game on the line, Jankovic went to him twice yesterday, and he converted at the free throw line after being fouled to put the game away. Josh Jones also in the game, number 5 in white, a very deep Creighton team. Here's McDermott against that size of Wilkins you were talking about. Manages to wheel it in.
Well, Tyler Brown that time, kind of a half double team, was playing off of Gibbs, never really committed. Still forced McDermott to turn away from the defense.
All 5 of the Creighton field goals coming in the painted area. And they can knock down 3s too.
I still like establishing that first and then building out. You force Illinois State maybe to make adjustments defensively, and then you can start looking at your 3.
Moore is fouled by Chapman as he makes his drive.
Well, here's the look. He knows, he sees people around him, awareness of where defense is, what's giving you. And then you put a lot of pressure on the defender when you face up from about 10 feet.
Just over 5 minutes gone here in St. Louis.
Many people surprised that he wasn't first team MVC and put the great numbers. I think it's going to be critical for him, Tim, to stay out of foul trouble in this game. The face up right here against Artino shows that he's got the nice little 1-2 bounce game and the mid-range jump shot.
Artino, the freshman from Iowa, picking up the personal foul, and the old-fashioned three-pointer goes for Jackie Carmichael from Manhattan, Kansas, South Kent Prep. And Ethan Rogge is coming to the game, the sophomore from Eden Prairie, Minnesota. Watch for him. He's a guy that when everyone's concentrating on McDermott, can knock down shots from the wing. Speaking of McDermott, nicely done off the entry bounce pass from Grant Gibbs.
Wow, and that's a really underrated skill, the post feed.
Gibbs the rebound. Creighton scored on their last 6 trips down the floor.
That's what Tim Kingfish said to us yesterday. We asked him, what do you do when they're making shots defensively? And he kind of shrugged and said, I don't know. I really don't know what to do. They're that good.
Not there for Gibbs. Rebound to Illinois State. And here goes Moore. He's the little engine that could. He really is. That time, the little engine with a stutter step, and he got whistled by Stewart for the turnover. Well, tonight on CBS, an exhausting challenge leaves teams struggling in South America. Don't miss a new Amazing Race tonight, only CBS. Illinois State going to its bench as well, as Anthony Cousin had some injury issues from Alaska, makes his way onto the floor.
They've got depth out in the perimeter. It's along the front line that they're really thin, and they've got to keep guys in the game.
Find too many better bench coaches in college basketball than Jankovic. He has learned from some of the best. McDermott.
You know, it's not what the play is, it's who's running it. And those guys running a pick and pop on that side is deadly. You've got to respect both of them. And Illinois State really got caught on the interchange.
First 3 of the afternoon for the Dougie. Last year we had the Jimmer, this year the Dougie. And an answer from Ikey. And you believe John Ikey, who struggled with his shot yesterday, needs to have a warm afternoon today.
I think he's the X factor. You know, at home against Creighton, 1 of 8, 0 of 5 from 3. They need his offense desperately.
Blue Jays by 2, and they're shooting lights out. Rogge, not there. And the rebound corralled by Cousin. And
And the wing jumper doesn't fall for Cousin. Pulled down by Rocky, and he gets it right into the hands of Anthony Chapman.
That's what you'll see a lot from the Redbirds. They like to drive and pitch, looking for the three.
McDermott again.
You know what I love? You got a play that's working, you go right back to it, and they've done it twice in a row now.
And right away, Jankovic sees that they've got a flaw in their defensive attack as McDermott has hit their last 10, and the Blue Jays lead by 5. The Redbirds only fitting in St. Louis, but the big bad Blue Jay has warmed up.
There you see the numbers, 742 points. It happened on the first three a moment ago, two shots ago. The single season school record for points, 742 for the Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year.
You know, and it's interesting, Tim, we talked to him yesterday. He did not want to play for his dad. He was not going to go to Iowa State. And when this opportunity came open, his dad asked me, he said, would you like to go to Creighton with me? He said, absolutely.
His relationship with Coach Jacobson, though, and their family's relationship had a lot to do with them being able to pull that off. McDermott spent four seasons at Iowa State, and during that time, of course, he was a teammate of Harrison Barnes, now of North Carolina fame, won a couple of state titles together.
Yeah, those two again, high school basketball in Iowa. What are you kidding me?
Can you believe that? Here's Allen, and the football player of the past at Minnesota, Bryant Allen. He is a spark off their bench, a real energy guy.
Keep in mind, in the two games against Creighton, he averaged 23 points. Really saw a big basket against them. Has a lot of confidence playing against this team.
By way of Maplewood, Missouri, just outside St. Louis. So he's got a lot of friends and family nearby. You know he's pumped up for this tournament final. That wing jumper won't go. Rogge was pushed, though. That's one of those cheap ones for Wilkins, I think. May have gone against Eakey. Eakey got caught with the push. 22 in red. So Creighton will have it when we return to St. Louis. Already, three have been ticketed to dance. Belmont out of the Atlantic Sun. Congratulations to Coach Bird and his staff. UNC Asheville. We saw them a year ago. Eddie Biedenbaugh's club, champions of the Big South. And Steve Prohm's Murray State Racers of the OVC with only one loss. They avenged that loss yesterday. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski. I don't know about you, but it's great to get that pre-NCAA tournament feel in a conference championship setting like this.
You know, it was a great atmosphere in the building today. And it's a, I think Creighton is there. They're going to be in the tournament. But this is a huge game for Illinois State and a lot of red out in the crowd today.
And a lot of bubble teams and power conferences quite concerned about the potential outcome. Look at these clubs. Their chances are adversely affected with an Illinois State win.
Well, I'm not one to root, and we're not in the rooting business, but Northwestern, that would be a heck of a story getting in the first time. That would be a great storyline in the tournament.
North Carolina State will be playing Virginia Tech later tonight. They certainly need another win. They got one against Miami the other day for Mark Gottfried in his first year with that program. And Chinique inside does not get that one to fall. The iron was unkind, but it's out of bounds off Illinois State.
I think Tim Jankovic a little over thought there was an over-the-back foul that time by Chinique, but you could see where they're both playing off of each other. His game inside has opened up the perimeter, and they're knocking down threes, so that doesn't allow Illinois State to double inside.
Avery Dingman is coming to the game. The Creighton inside game, as you mentioned, turning up the outside perimeter game. Their last two field goals from McDermott coming from downtown after that efficiency you spoke of inside. Nice drive by Young, and he draws the contact inside. That foul will go against Wilkins. Tuesday on CBS, when it comes to solving mysteries, she can do anything but forget. Poppy Montgomery and Dylan Walsh star in Unforgettable Tuesday, only CBS.
Well, I think with Antoine Young, to the extent that you can, and they did that time, you have to force him right. I mean, he's so good going with a strong hand that you take your chances, but then you can't bail him out and put him on the free throw line.
Rogge and Josh Jones sit down. McDermott back on the floor, along with Avery Dingman and
Menegau. And Wilkins now with two quick fouls here in the first half. G-Man has to sit down, but they do get Carmichael back on the floor with Eakin, so they have not sacrificed size as yet. Carmichael, well, he's got versatility to his game. Well defended, though, there by Etienne.
But if now Eakin and Carmichael, neither one of them can get in foul trouble the rest of the way. There's nobody really behind them.
With the dump down. Echenique, very aggressive.
Yeah, that's a great play because he, and you saw Carmichael really had a lay off him and almost let that one go.
Creighton by five as we reach the halfway point in the opening half. Gregory Echenique with six. It's exactly what Doug McDermott was telling us he needed in this game, his fellow player, is for that young man to be aggressive.
Well, this is just good post play right here, and I just wish more young guys would learn that hook shot, and it's part of what Echenique does, and it's a great, great weapon. Puts a lot of pressure. It's almost unblockable there. You see the numbers in the semifinal against Evansville, and Greg McDermott said it's probably his best game in a Creighton uniform.
That was a move that you utilized from time to time in your days at Duke with Bill Foster. This is your first trip back to St. Louis since that 78 Final Four.
Thanks, Tim. I've almost gotten over that.
Carmichael can't connect, and Menegau comes out of there with it.
I got off the plane, and Givens was there to meet me, making jump shots.
That one does not fall for Avery Dingman. It's also fitting today that we saw our colleagues at Westwood One. The radio broadcast crew includes Kyle Macy.
All right, enough of the game, all right?
That's a rubbing some salt in the wound for you, I know. Carmichael setting a little pick. Nick Moore, what a nice move. Right over McDermott, but he forced it a little bit. Menegau comes out of there with him. Those wing jumpers are there, but so far Avery Dingman not able to ring the bell.
Starting to come down a little bit. They hit their first two threes, but now missed their last seven.
This kid from Indiana, Warsaw High School, is really good. Moore does not fall that time for Anthony Cousin. Both teams hitting a bit of a drop. And Juan Young had a free move into the painted area that time.
He is very aggressive going end to end on the floor. You've got to stop the advance of the dribble. Nobody for Illinois State getting in front of him.
Echenique coming out, and Hedging picks up the personal foul, kind of a giveaway, and Greg McDermott pointing that out to him as he'll be replaced.
And it's just everybody seemingly running away from the basketball instead of clamping down on him and making him pitch. But Tim, that's where Echenique, he cannot pick up fouls that far away from the basket, hedging on screens. They're wasted fouls that far out.
Artino comes back into the game for him, number 31. And Grant Gibbs, number 10, also back onto the floor. Eakey, who is playing with two fouls, lost his dribble, and then it's out of bounds. Good pressure that time from Gibbs. Creighton with 10 field goals, no turnovers. Pretty efficient, wouldn't you say, for the Blue Jays early on. Both teams are playing very sharply on offense as we take a look at our state of the game summary, Mike Jaminski.
Well, right now, Creighton points in the paint, the big advantage there, and a lot of it, their All-American candidate has been doing an incredible job, but Doug McDermott showing you all the things that he can do on the floor here early, posting up, work, establishing himself in the paint, and then two consecutive pick and rolls for threes. He's already at double figures with 10 points, but he's only taken five shots. A very, very efficient player.
There's really not a move that he doesn't have. He can post you up. He'll lock you down, go with that up and under maneuver of his. And I think his passing skills are probably overlooked by many people.
And he doesn't care whether he gets 40 points in the game or 14 points in the game. He really is unflappable and plays the same way. His teammates love him. And that's the thing about this Creighton team. Everybody plays within themselves.
is a flaw to this team. They may not be the greatest defensive team, and their coach will tell you that. I mean, Greg McDermott will admit it readily. But in the flow of the game, they always get good shots. And when you're looking at the tournament one and done, a team that's got many options, they have plenty of them.
I'd rather be a great offensive team and maybe an above-average defensive team than the other way around.
There's Gibbs staying with it.
That's just me. I love the firepower this team has.
25-16, largest lead of the afternoon for the Blue Jays. And Gibbs has been pretty stout. 6 points, 5 boards for him. Moore from downtown. Illinois State in need of a hoop and probably a stop. Wouldn't hurt at this stage either.
You talk about that, but I think in the first 14 minutes of this game that Creighton's done a very good job defensively against Illinois State scores.
How about that near put back by Gibbs, and then McDermott polishes up. Gibbs almost with a miracle tip in with a lot of contact, and now it's a double-digit Blue Jays lead.
They are destroying Illinois State on the glass, 19-8 on this point. A lot of that's been on the offensive end. 8 offensive rebounds.
7-0 in second chance points as well. Tyler Brown really being bothered by Menegai, and that time Menegai got a little bit too aggressive and picked up the foul.
And this is the key thing here. I mean, you get a soft shot right there, but what Gibbs does, you can't get it. Keep it alive for somebody else, and he makes the play happen for McDermott.
Carmichael, Brown, Nick Moore, Eke, who you thought at the beginning of the day was going to be very important, and Brian Allen, their best offensive club probably on the floor right now for Tim Jankovic. They need a basket here. In a very large way. I know it's early, but Creighton is so explosive. You have to maintain contact. Moore in traffic. Not there. Carmichael keeping it alive. Needs some help. Finally gets some. Brown. Right there.
He did the right thing. He drove Adortino out of that double team and got a good look, but just could not make the shot go down.
They are scoreless now, the Redbirds, for the last 6 minutes. Droughts like that against teams like this can be devastating. Gibbs with a bounce pass entry to McDermott against that double team. I think he may have taken an extra step. He did. That's the first turnover of the afternoon for Creighton.
You look at, you were talking to Greg McDermott yesterday, the assist to turnover ratio as a team is mind-boggling for them. As fast as they play on the year, 550 assists, only 380 turnovers.
Now coming up on AT&T at the half, join Greg and Seth for all the scores and highlights, plus a preview of Ohio State, Michigan State. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Well, the Big Ten is back in play again for the Buckeyes after Michigan State's loss to Indiana. See if Jared Sullinger's team can pull off a road win after being beaten by them earlier. That was a much-needed bucket, and the two guys that made it happen, Moore and Carmichael.
A good screen roll that time, getting him something where he's not a stationary target, much more difficult to defend.
That ended a drought of 0 for 7 in a 6.5-minute period without a field goal for Illinois State. Young, a leader, offensive foul. Well done by Brown going in there to collect the charge, and Tim Jankovic really happy to see that.
Once again, they've really done a nice job forcing him right. Doing a good job of committing yourself to taking the charge that time. Probably one dribble too many for Young, and should have pulled up and shot the little floater.
So after no turnovers in the last two trips, a pair have been committed now by Creighton.
Same pick and roll action. Much better job that time, Creighton covering it up.
Moore pulls up. Look out if he warms up. He is a pass-first point, but he's not shy about taking big shots in big moments.
Brown missed his first 4 attempts, too, so a confidence builder for him right there.
Brown. Shanique out there, and a foul spotted underneath. Goes against Grant Gibbs. Coming up after our under four timeout, we'll have an opportunity to visit with Tim Jankovic out of the break, the counterpart to Greg McDermott. We'll talk to him about having experienced this drought and yet maintaining contact.
This is a sequence here, Mike.
It's very important for his team. They just went without a basket for 6.5 minutes, but they're only down 7.
Well, he talked to us yesterday, and he felt like they were very fortunate to be within shouting distance at the half against Wichita State with all the troubles that they had, and he may be feeling the same way about this game.
There you see him with his staff, Anthony Bean, Rob Judson, and Paris Parham. He has great respect for his staff, having been an assistant. He gave up a head coaching opportunity at North Texas when they went from the Southland Conference. He actually played in the championship game in Monroe, Louisiana in his first year there. They changed leagues, and he thought he just, with all the guaranteed games that they were going to have to play at that next level, he decided to walk away from 4 years remaining on a contract, become an assistant, and it paid dividends for him. Now he's gotten a great opportunity at Illinois State after working for the likes of Kevin Stallings and Bill Self. Shanique comes over to set the pick. Shot clock down to 5. Great defensive work being done, but did we have a whistle prior?
I think it's going to be on Nick Moore. I think it's going to be on Nick Moore inside.
Nick Moore will pick it up. On that overplay, he got a little too physical. We'll talk with Tim Jankovic when we come out of the break. His team just trying to stay with the Blue Jays. Okay. 27-22 our score. The Creighton Blue Jays leading by 5. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski. We're joined now by Tim Jankovic. Coach, thanks for the time. Your club went over 6 minutes without scoring a bucket, and yet they're in this game. You must feel good about that.
Story of our tournament. We haven't had a good offensive tournament since we've been here. We haven't shot the ball really well, and we're just trying to scratch around on the defensive end, and hopefully we can open it up on the offensive end.
Tim, 8 offensive rebounds for them for second chance points. What do you need to do to clean up the glass?
Blockout. Well, a terrible blockout. I think we got caught up in the moment. Championship game. We're watching balls, hoping they bounce it. We got to block out a lot better, much better.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you.
You know, one of the things he told us yesterday, Mike, was that the last couple of weeks, these young guys, and this is a very young team he has, haven't played together much. Number of transfers. Really, Carmichael is the old man in the city. It's really only his second year. But they really bought in defensively. It just kind of clicked, he said, the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, and it's been a learning experience. Like I say, most of his perimeter players, this is their first year with the program, either through transfers or being freshmen or junior college players. But nice time for it to click in.
Yeah,
you know, if it's going to click in as you get ready for the tournament, it's as good as we can be.
You would not expect to have a poor shooting game and still beat the top seed Wichita State, a club that I really could be very hard to beat in the opening week of the NCAA tournament. And Shanique, with that elbow out, gets tagged for the foul as Carmichael hit the deck.
When you're in the post, you've got to fight for position with your body, not with your elbows. And Carmichael's taking some inventory right there. He got hit hard.
Yes, he did.
And that was not a flop.
It was Brian Allen that got knocked silly yesterday against Wichita State. And then Wilkins got teed up twice and left the game. And they played shorthanded and still won. And you can see he pushed off right there.
Well, I think what they're going to do now, the referees are going to look and see if there were elbows involved and where it was involved. The contact happened before that play. That was the net result.
We had one of these stoppages yesterday before they determined that Wilkins was guilty of a flagrant one against Wichita State.
The good news for Carmichael so far in this game, which he had to do, is to stay out of foul trouble.
Yeah, the left elbow.
That may
be worthy of one. That was a left elbow as he was clearing out, as our friend Clark Kellogg, Special K, would call it, the chicken wing. And really the
and that was up in the head area,
yeah,
too.
Yeah. The left elbow that you saw from the first replay is probably what they're more interested in. There was a push with the right elbow as well that sent Carmichael to the floor.
This has been one of the recent rule changes where they can go over and the referees can look at all three of them. This is interesting. Normally one or two be over there, but all three of the officials are over there reviewing this play.
Scott Thornley, Michael Stewart, and Kelly Self for the officials. And you see the trainers taking a pretty long look at Carmichael along the sidelines for Illinois State.
And I think they're going to call. I thought they saw the sign was it was going to be a flagrant one.
Yeah, and it's the left elbow coming up first, and then the push. Right, this is the elbow we were talking about, right there. Michael Stewart's coming over to explain to Michael.
We got a flagrant one.
It is a flagrant one.
Zero.
Uh huh. Thank you, Michael. Illinois State ball underneath. Thank you, Michael. So that left elbow was the flagrant,
right,
foul.
Right. Yeah, and that's it definitely wasn't a flagrant too, but it'll be two free throws and Illinois State's ball.
Gary, it's a 6-0 run plus these free throws.
I think you need to explain again the differences. The two coaches are being informed now by the officials, the differences between flagrant one and flagrant two.
Well, and the flagrant two is one is the excessive force, whether it's a punch or, you know, something that was thrown in anger or you know, teeing somebody up and trying to hit him. That was a basketball play, but yeah. I mean, he got his elbows up high, and that's the thing that really triggers the call, anything above the shoulder area. So I think the referees did I thought they handled that perfectly.
The thing that you have to be mindful of as a coach is when those fouls come your way, they count as personals and they add up over time. Yesterday, it really cost Jankovic's team with Wilkins. So Echenique now has three fouls because it counts as a personal. So you had two. Now with the flagrant one, you're talking about three.
Right, I thought interesting too. Instead of coming back with Artino, that Greg McDermott now has got a smaller team out on the floor, but a little more a team that can spread you with Roggi being able to shoot the three.
Yeah, 34. Ethan Roggi, the sophomore from Eden Prairie, is who's come in. See the Creighton. Now they're explaining who can take the shots. But this partisan crowd from Creighton finding out now that Echenique has three fouls. This is a very well-read basketball town, Omaha, Nebraska. The enrollment there is about over 7,000. And they, for home games, have 10,000 more than that at every game. So the town of Omaha has really adopted Creighton University basketball.
And E.K. will be the chosen one to shoot the free throws at 77%.
Independence, Missouri. Can't get that one to go.
I'll tell you what, Tim, it's different. When you're shooting a technical foul, it's a completely different vibe. You're out there all by yourself. You're used to having guys up and down the lane.
Did you see
it's one and two?
You see those fat heads that the Creighton fans are putting up? One of them belongs to an 88-year-old woman by the name of Marianne Phillippe. She is not on this trip, but she's become a mascot of sorts for this team, a sort of Midwestern Betty White, if you will. Her late husband was a dentist and a Creighton student, and she goes to games. They caught a picture of her raising the roof at a game, and she's become a rock star in Omaha, Nebraska. So, Marianne, I hope you're enjoying our broadcast today back in Omaha.
You know, if you were just watching this, then you would think that Creighton is dominating this game, but Illinois State hanging around.
Roggi, you mentioned he can shoot it, and there he does.
This is a much different team without their true centers out there. They can really spread the floor.
This crowd and perhaps this team has taken that flagrant one against Echenique personally. That bucket, by the way, ended a 7-0 spurt for Illinois State. Ryan Allen can't hit. Long rebound taken down by Austin Chapman. He's got quite a motor.
leaves it for McDermott for three.
Off the front iron.
You expect all of his to go.
You know what, that is, you know, they named the Valley Player of the Year after Larry Bird, and that was a Larry Bird type shot.
Yes,
trailing down, going for the dagger, the crowd's in it. Hit another three, extend the lead a little bit.
Off the secondary break.
Yeah.
Moore. He connects, playing the nylon song, and it's 30-25.
Allen and Brown have been pretty quiet so far in this half, so they're needing other people to step up.
Young leaves it up top. Not there for Chapman.
Pulled down by Zeke Upshaw's into the game. There's Brian Allen. He rattles it home.
This scoring pace, and Greg McDermott not liking what he sees right now, but this scoring pace very much to Illinois State's liking.
The Redbirds saying a return to sender for the Blue Jays, a 12-3 run, down only two.
There's been a lot of talk about the Chevy Volt lately. How about some facts? The Chevy Volt was one of the most awarded cars in 2011. The Volt's battery has been tested for more than 395,000 hours. And most importantly, the Volt has received the highest overall vehicle score for safety possible. The extended range, electric Chevy Volt. Hard to argue with the facts.
Here in the Missouri Valley Conference, as G-Man mentioned, the Larry Bird Player of the Year, Doug McDermott of Creighton, the Dougie, and the Coach of the Year, Greg Marshall, a guy we've known for a long time since his days as an assistant with John Kress and over at Winthrop where he took them to NCAAs. He has really gotten the Wheat Shockers back on the front pages.
Well, and how about McDermott, Doug McDermott? His dad was thinking about redshirting him last year.
He said, how smart am I?
Yeah, he played him. Freshman of the year, first team All-Valley, and then he's now an All-American candidate.
So much for that blueprint. Very entertaining first 20 minutes here in St. Louis.
Well, he's got Carmichael on him, and they're going to run that little screen roll again. Now they got Carmichael on Young on the switch.
There's where they want it, McDermott on the reach-in foul. Committed by Tyler Brown.
Just constant motion right then, and just shaping up. Nice play in front of the lane.
Icky's got his jersey.
He gets caught behind him.
Yeah, the foul was on Brown, but Icky clearly had some jersey. He puts up with a lot of contact and just stays with it. How about that pass? And another one. And they do everything but convert. Right to Gibbs, and he missed the bunny. Two beautiful interior passes there. But no conversion.
Yeah, no, it's their shot. We talked about their numbers, over 50% on the year, but they are at 41 right now, 25% from three. So you mentioned the fact of Tim Jankovic saying their defense has really clicked in the last 2 weeks, that they're doing a fine job against a very potent offense.
Martino comes into the game for McDermott in the closing seconds here. They don't want him to pick up a cheapie. Illinois State, this is unbelievable to think that they have a chance to tie or take the lead before the intermission. It's been a Creighton first half, really.
Yeah, and the longer you let a team hang around, the more confidence they get. This is exactly what happened against Wichita State yesterday. They find themselves in a two-minute game with Illinois State, and they got burned.
Redbirds last led this game 6-4. That was a long time ago. Cousin to initiate, over to Tyler Brown.
He knocks it down, and they do lead 31-30. Manigault off the back iron. It would have counted had it gone. The upstart Redbirds trying to say, we want to march in March. Whether there's a bid that you want to send us, we'll force you with an automatic. A 15-3 run to close out the half. That's our score. Let's send you to New York. Griff Gumbel, Greg.
Thank you, guys. Coming up on AT&T at the half. Scores and highlights, and Greg and Seth go one-on-one in a friendly game of bracket ball after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports coverage of the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship is sponsored by the all-new Buick Verano, unexpected luxury in a car this size. Buffalo Wild Wings, wings, beer, sports. And by Craftsman, trust in your hands.
Concerned as the Blue Jays golden girl back home in Omaha looks on. Her team is down here at halftime. Tim Brando along with Mike Jaminski. Good to see you got the clothing memo today. You look sharp.
Thank you, sir. Wish I could say the same for you.
So does this Illinois State team look pretty sharp, and especially in the late stages of the first half.
I thought they defended very well. This is a very high-scoring team. They average almost 80 points a game in playing on Creighton, and they are well behind that pace right now. That's the reason why Illinois State has a one-point lead.
Let's take a look at the Mercedes-Benz first half stats, and look, the time with the lead at the bottom tells you all you need to know.
All that matters is you lead at the end of the game if it's for the last 2 seconds, so what? But they cleaned up the rebounds a little bit and really have done a pretty nice job overall defensively.
It was a 15-3 run to close out the first half for Illinois State. But McDermott, you know, you talk about shots and how effective he can be. He was both inside and out.
Yeah, he really did a nice job. He established himself in the paint area, then went out and hit a couple of threes. But they need somebody else to step up. I mean, you look at it that he and Echenique are 8 of 12 from the field. The rest of the team, 5 of 19.
Ike's shot does not fall. It goes out of bounds. We do want to correct one item from the flagrant one foul that occurred a bit earlier. Had there been a technical whistle, that can count as a personal foul, but it was just a flagrant one foul. No additional foul on Echenique. So rather than three, he does have just 2 personal fouls. Obviously, that's an important factoid as we begin the second half. Echenique working inside to get 3 against Carmichael.
Still not really coming down and double-teaming Echenique, but just forcing him out of the paint area.
Manigaud knocks down the three-pointer. Jaheens Manigaud from Ottawa, Ontario. 33-31 Creighton.
They need to find other people from behind the arc who are going to step up and make shots.
Just as you authored here at halftime, Manigaud gets his first bucket, and it's a three-ball. Three-point shooting for both teams. Crisply played first half. We'll see what happens in the second with a championship and an automatic bid into the NCAA tournament at stake. That's a block. Manigaud was trying to induce with the flop. Did not work.
Well, you can see right here that Manigaud, you know, I'm open, fellas. Cut the ball out to me. Sometimes you have to jump up and down and scream and stamp your feet a little bit.
Nick Moore, in a lot of respects, this freshman is the real engine for this team. His emergence has helped. That time, Carmichael unavailable to get that one. Pass was a little bit low. A rejection by Carmichael. Brian Allen has Brown with him. Alley-oop! Oh! That brings the Redbird crowd up, and we're going to get a whistle for a technical for hanging on the rim.
And it's, such a highly charged atmosphere. You get emotional, you get a play like that, but he did do a little pull-up on the end of it. That was a good call. Well, it's Ike who comes in from behind and gets the play on the block.
Yeah.
Good solid play, and that triggers the break. And here's right there.
You got to just
finish the play and let it go.
No one underneath you. It's not a slam dunk show. It's a championship game. You're right.
I mean, you can't. I mean, these guys have a lead against this team in the championship game. You're 20 minutes from going to the NCAA tournament. It's tough to keep your emotions in check, but you have to. That was the right call. The crowd there, A lot of booing from the Illinois State crowd, but that was the correct call.
It was. The good news is it happened very early, and it's still a two-point game. McDermott. Right past Eke. Eke got another one.
Second block in a row.
Two blocks and two possessions for him. Allen pumps from downtown. Out of bounds, last touched by Echenique.
Well, he's doing a fine job against McDermott. Not going for the pump fake, holding his ground and going up on the shot. Terrific post defense.
Tough assignment against the player of the year in the conference, and he answered the challenge. Moore, baseline to Brian Allen. That rainbow hits nothing. McDermott comes down with it. Antoine Young working against Moore. It again.
Echenique has not been real demonstrative in trying to catch the ball. He's had him on the high post.
Gibbs is a garbage man, isn't he? He just takes his lunch pail and goes to the 10. That was a poor lob by Echenique, intended for McDermott, and then there to clean it up was Gibbs.
Well, how many 50-50 balls has he gotten in this game? Yeah. On the offensive glass, really just has a nose for the ball.
Yeah, he and Eke, 22 in red, very similar talents on the floor. Role players that are getting the job done for their collective teams. Allen in traffic, almost turned it over. Shot clock is at 3. I don't know that Moore knows it.
Oh! He rattles home an NBA 3. 37-36.
What a bailout from your point guard. He looked up at the last second and knew he had to get something up at the rim.
I don't think he saw the clock till late. Offensive foul on Doug McDermott.
How about this? These are the shots that win championships for you early on in the game. 1 second on the clock. And that's like, hey, Tim, that's just how you drew it up, right?
You think of the guys that played for Jack Hartman through the years. Jankovic was fortunate enough to do that at Kansas State. Lon Kruger. There's a lot of Lon in Jankovic's approach to the game. Very even-keeled guy. And his team has really responded these last few weeks. They finished 9-9 in conference play. Making a tremendous run in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. Trying to win it all and get a bid. Carmichael, he is fouled on the way up.
Well, they're a 4-seed, Tim. I mean, yeah. It's not like it's a complete Cinderella story.
Not at all. They're a good team.
Yeah, there are a lot of things that you said that happened in the last couple of weeks for this ball club.
You finish 9-9 in this league, you're playing some ball because it's a quality conference.
Well, and they've got a big piece missing in Jordan Treloff.
That's right. Who
gives them some depth along the front line. He broke his thumb in practice. So that's a big part that's missing.
And yesterday they made that comeback without Wilkins, without Carmichael, and Brian Allen was hurt for a period of it. There's Treloff, you mentioned, youngster from DeKalb, Illinois, which is the home of the Huskies of Northern Illinois University.
And they've been able to play this game without foul trouble, which is kind of mitigated his absence out on the floor. They really survived yesterday with that, but things setting up well for them in the last 16 minutes of this game.
4 minutes gone by. We're tied at 37. Young rejected by Carmichael. Timeout. We are flying high in St. Louis, Louis, the land of the Golden Arch. The Redbirds, the Blue Jays, trying to make it to next week. The Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. LG is a proud NCAA corporate sponsor, invites you to celebrate game day moments.
So far, we talked about the defensive effort for Illinois State. Creighton has taken 5 shots. 3 of them have been blocked so far.
The intensity level in this game, I think, really did pick up from the moment that flagrant one foul occurred, which was part of a 15-3 run to close out the first half for Illinois State. And it's just carried over the intensity level even higher here in the opening moments of the second. Avery Dingman will trigger it in for Creighton. Antoine Young running the show. And McDermott coming out high looking for Echenique. Working on Carmichael, now doubled. Never left his feet. There's a steal. Off the trap, Tyler Brown. And a return to center. Maginot takes it away. Loose ball, and Antoine Young finally clears it. Two Blue Jays on the deck. Young is rejected, an offensive foul committed. What a harum scarum moment that was on both ends for both Illinois State and Creighton.
Now, that time, Antoine Young just a little out of control. They got fortunate on the other end that Manigault had a nice job defensively to save that play. And that's the referees in this game, Tim, have tended to call charges.
Yes.
They're trending that way, so you really have to be careful about carrying the drive too far.
But they've been consistent with it.
And they've been consistently right. So that's, you know, you have to adjust.
Brown off the pick and roll to Carmichael, out of bounds, last touch by Echenique. Well, coming up next, a big time blowout for the Big Ten lead. Jared Sullinger and the Buckeyes of Ohio State with a throwdown against Draymond Green and the Michigan State Spartans.
Draymond Green having an outstanding year, player of the year in that conference, I'm fairly sure.
Yes.
You know, he's
well, when you start getting calls from Magic Johnson about your leadership role, that probably is a good indicator. And Tom Izzo told me about a week or so ago, he actually asked Magic to call Draymond. That's how much Draymond has been meaning to that program. There's Carmichael from the elbow.
Does have that ability, and that's going to set up a drive for him because he can put the ball on the floor.
Three turnovers in the last three possessions for Creighton. Dingman, who's not been able to hit that wing jumper, he's got it in his arsenal. There's Echenique. Has a step. Rushed that one a little bit. Wilkins pulls it down.
Well, point blank range. You have to use the backboard in that situation. He was right there, tried to put it in the rim and missed.
It in. A little stick-to-itiveness there.
Right now, the Redbirds just playing with a lot more energy. They're quicker to the basketball. They're quicker off the floor.
Young with an oop for Echenique. Nicely done by Antoine Young on the feed to Gregory Echenique. That ended an 8-0 spurt.
Tim, the whole vibe in the building has changed right now. It's 14 minutes to an NCAA tournament bid.
No doubt about it. And if you have not, as they say, gotten the memo about what March means, these fans and these players and coaches have. Look at that. Another answer. Tyler Brown gets it done. And Allen comes away with a foul.
Yeah, not a smart play. Tried for the home run steal and picks up a foul.
But Ryan Allen, they've taken the air out of a couple of incredible moments with the technical foul hanging on the rim and then Allen's over aggression there. That's the old football inning coming out. Played both football and basketball at Minnesota before transferring. Young. Nice strong move by Antoine Young, the senior from nearby Bellevue, Nebraska, very close to Omaha.
So that one much more under control. That's, you know, you want to be aggressive but under control in that situation.
Jankovic mentioned to us yesterday, in terms of leadership, particularly in the backcourt, Allen's really that guy. He's such an energy player. As he gets better, he begins to take over. Carmichael has been the constant, though, and he is playing large right now.
Well, Jackie Carmichael in double figures, and they've been using him out on the floor a lot more in screen rolls.
Young was rejected. That's four blocks in this first 5 minutes plus of the second half for Illinois State. Carmichael walked.
John Eakey will check back into the game. These are the teams that will be very nervous if Illinois State pulls this off. UConn, you could say that both of the UConn and NC State have a chance to do damage in their conference tournaments, and they do. Mississippi State has been reeling of late, and they likely are looking at a chance in the SEC tournament of doing damage. And how about Tennessee? Konzo Martin's team, officially the number two seed in the SEC behind Kentucky at 10-6. What a comeback by his team.
He was in this conference last year, won the regular season at Missouri State, and then got the call after everything with Bruce Pearl went down. Well, I was going to say, nice to see Jim Calhoun back on the bench for friends. I just hope he didn't rush things.
Doug McDermott will get credit for that hoop. That swat was an illegal one by Illinois State.
Got the good front. The Wilkins was a little bit late getting over here. Good call on the way down up on the glass.
I think the committee may have to take into account also Jarnell Stokes' impact at Tennessee, how they played since he's gotten into the lineup as a potential run if Tennessee were to get all the way to the finals. They will not meet Kentucky until the finals of the SEC after finishing second in that league. And there's another whistle spotted by Mike Stewart inside as Rogge got involved with Illinois State underneath. There you see the alumni of outstanding coaches from this conference.
And Mark Turgeon, of course, in the ACC now. Maryland, Steve Offerson, a lot of talent coming through this league.
You bet.
A lot of coaching talent.
Well, Coach Lowry just let go at Southern Illinois. There's already been quite a lot of conversation. If Bruce Weber, who some believe may be in a precarious spot in Champaign, he might even come back to Carbondale and coach at Southern Illinois. A lot of published reports indicating that. Little pick and pop for Wilkins. Too strong, Dingman the rebound. Austin Chapman, number one, running the show for Creighton.
Creighton going with that smaller lineup, letting McDermott work in the post.
There are those moves we talk about. And he can go to that left hand, such a versatile talent. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local CBS stations.
Are you ready for this?
Whoa, what a play!
Here he shoots.
Yes. Oh, so strong!
Wow.
He got it! There is no better time of year.
Our great quartet of networks bring you every game through television, through TV, TBS, TNT, and CBS. Don't forget the selection show on March 11th, the first four, of course, after that in Dayton, Ohio. Last year was first four to Final Four for VCU, Mike, and of course, a Final Four here at the Jones Dome back in 2005 with North Carolina and company captured the national championship.
Against Illinois and Coach Weber. You look at it tonight, I think that was a wildly successful tournament last year. Everybody coming up to me and saying what a great presentation it was.
As an example, we had probably the most memorable game of the second and third rounds with that Pitt-Butler game, the way it finished. Both teams winning and losing it in the last 2.6 seconds. I dare say that without the presentation we had a year ago, not as many people would have known about it, and it would not have resonated as long as it did without it.
Yeah, it was just the marriage of Turner and CBS went absolutely smoothly. So it was great thing to be a part of. Looking forward to being there again this year.
Another reason for you to set up Sir Charles. Your old running mate in Philadelphia. Tied at 45 with 11 and change in the Missouri Valley Conference Championship at stake. Eakey!
Both teams have been running that pick and pop on the same side of the floor. Talked about Eakey, 40% from three, so he is a very capable shooter.
Boy, Jankovic really told us yesterday that he hoped John Eakey could have a big day because he could play a lot better than he did yesterday. His words were prophetic. Gibbs can't connect. Allen trying to keep it alive. I believe it was off Rogge as he had hit the inline, and it's controlled to the Redbirds. Illinois State shooting a 60% clip in the last 14 minutes of this game.
Greg McDermott has gone more and more with this smaller lineup, having both of the centers out on the floor, letting McDermott work in the low box.
Cousin looking for Allen. Give and go game, two-man game between he and Moore. McDermott brings down the rebound.
They had so much success with that screen and roll and that pick and pop with McDermott early on. Why don't they don't go back to that?
Rogge from downtown. Off the back iron, Gibbs, a 50-50 ball again. But Illinois State this time comes out of there with it. Wilkins. Ikey is feeling it. He is feeling it. Give number 22 the ball. He wants it. 51-45.
Three of four from the floor, all of them from behind the arc. A huge lift for the Redbirds.
He's got 10 on the day. McDermott. That a whistle, I believe. A block will be the call. Underneath, as McDermott was making his move against Wilkins.
Watch this. This good extra pass by Wilkins, and then another kick. That is really unselfish basketball right there. Treloff giving the sign.
Treloff enjoying it at the end of that bench. Meanwhile, it is the fourth foul on John Wilkins underneath. Youngster from France. If you're wondering how John Wilkins managed to navigate his way to Illinois State, his dad was an All-America player back in 1977. He averaged 11 boards with Jeff Wilkins. So they knew about him, but he did not play organized basketball, American college basketball, until just a couple of years ago. Really a raw talent.
Well, this is interesting. Well, now it's Ikey is probably going to be the logical guy to match up against McDermott with Wilkins out. So both coaches going back to a traditional post out on the floor.
Well, the pace of the game has really been scintillating. You get the feeling, though, Mike, with what's on the line, that the last nine and change, the pace will slow down a little bit.
Right, and the rim will get a little bit smaller, too. And we'll see how the shooting continues.
Oh, Allen walked off the pressure defense from Gibbs. There was contact, but certainly it was incidental. A tough turnover for the Redbirds. Leading by four. Antoine Young operating at the point with McDermott setting that high pick. Echenique comes back the other way. On the wing, Josh Jones can't connect. And we had a whistle prior to the rebound. That foul is going to go against Gibbs.
Tim, yesterday Josh Jones came in and hit his first four threes, gave them a nice lift off the bench. He has not hit a shot in this game, 0 of 3.
Greg McDermott looking for an explanation from Mike Stewart, the official.
That's what he said. And the Doug has been a constant, but two of the other four perimeter guys have to give him something, especially his bench players.
That's the 16th foul now committed by the Blue Jays. Brown, a little whirling dervish in the paint, not there, and it's pulled down by Josh Jones. McDermott,
great post feed.
Was it ever by Jones?
Can't let a guy get position in front of you like that deep.
51-49, 22 on 7 of 10 for the Larry Bird Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year. That one was thrown up a bit too quickly by Tyler Brown. Jankovic didn't like it. Gives right back to McDermott.
Another great post feed. He is just getting prime real estate position on Ikey.
Timeout. Jankovic knows it. After losing Wilkins and no help for Ikey on defense, McDermott flexing his muscles. Feed and fan the best player in your conference. Josh Jones says hello, and so does Grant Gibbs. A little kiss says I do by that Blue Jay. CBS Sports coverage of the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship is sponsored by E-Trade, Investing Unleashed.
DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you've got to get DirecTV. And by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state.
Just a wonderful basketball environment within this conference, the Missouri Valley. And Mike Jaminski, as you look at that, 1996, Tulsa won the conference tournament championship. Since that year, every team within this conference has won this tournament and its championship. That just says so much for Doug Elgin's league. It really does.
Yeah, and it's Kevin Stallings was involved in those teams the last time they won it.
Yep.
And they have not won it since 98, so it would be huge for this program to pull off this victory.
Tied at 51 with just over 8 minutes remaining. McDermott has Creighton's last 10 points.
Second time in this game that he's scored 10 consecutive points.
Jankovic got that timeout. You know he wants to get a bucket right here. A quality shot, very important. Brown gets one up top.
You can see that rim starting to get smaller now for Illinois State.
He got the open look that he wanted.
Ikey trying to cover McDermott on his own. 22 on three. That's the game within the game right now. And he's got it right there.
Not this time. Carmichael the rebound.
He's been the guy. They've lifted Echenique and letting him be a screener out on the floor, but they're throwing McDermott down into the post.
Cousin in traffic. Tough shot. Well defended by Gibbs.
And again, no touch for Carmichael or Ikey, who've really been the two warm Redbirds of late.
Well, it's really becoming the half-court grinder, Mike, that we expected as the clock begins to wind down.
Well, again, but I still think that Creighton's the fresher team as a result of that blowout yesterday.
Right off the glass once more. An 8-0 spurt now for the Blue Jays, keyed by the last 12 points from McDermott.
I think you have to commit and double-team him. He's just been too efficient down in the low post. I know you take a chance with their perimeter, but he's killing you right now.
Brown in traffic. Leaves it. Boy, that was a beautiful dish. And I think it surprised Carmichael as he tries to save it and does beautifully to Brown. Moore comes away with it. And again, the perimeter shot's not falling, but look how hard Anthony Cousin fought for that ball.
Perimeter for Creighton has got to hang in there. There have been a lot of three-point shots and long rebounds.
Once again on the dribble drive, Tyler Brown in traffic. Just wills it up there. If anything, trying a little too hard, but a foul spotted underneath. And it's going to go against Tyler Brown, pushing off. Blue Jays are getting what they need from their do-everything player, Doug McDermott. He scored their last 12, and they've come from down 8 to take the lead for the Missouri Valley title. As we take a look at our State Farm State of the Game, you look at the numbers there, the shot blocking with Illinois State, but Carmichael has been quiet of late, as has John Ikey during this run by Creighton.
Well, again, there's a huge advantage for points in the paint, and it's been interesting that they've really worked Doug McDermott into the low box, letting him operate. I think that Illinois State's going to have to react to that defensively somehow, and then also get some things going to the rim. Their jump shots have not been falling in the last 4 minutes.
Ikey hasn't taken a shot since the 9:53 mark, so it's been over 4 minutes for him. After he made those two threes, the Blue Jays decided to take him away. He's not been able to get a good quality look at the basket, and out of the timeout, he's sitting down.
Well, I think for Illinois State, if you want to look to a guy to get you a little jump started here, it's got to be Carmichael to get him, involve him in some screen rolls, get him going into the lane, and get some touches.
He missed one shot during that 5 minute span at 6:03 remaining, but not many touches for him either. They've been a little too perimeter in the last 5 minutes, Illinois State. This 8-0 run has been on for better than 4 minutes.
Ron, that's, and also they made the switch. Wilkins with the 4 fouls. Let's keep an eye on that. He's back on McDermott.
Yeah, with Ekey sitting down, Wilkins back on the floor. Shot clock winding down for Antoine Young. Looking inside, it's picked off. Tyler Brown with the pilfer. Cross court again. Almost taking away the opportunity and then saying, oh, I'll go ahead and shoot it. Anthony Cousin, the junior from Alaska, puts it down.
I thought they really missed Carmichael coming down the lane, but Cousin steps up and makes him pay.
Yeah, he didn't really want to take that shot, did he?
Only after they simply were not going to cover him did he elect to take it. Young in traffic. That one was rejected by Wilkins, but Gibbs again just there to collect whatever garbage he can around the rim.
He really does a great job of setting up position aside. That was not a good shot attempt by Antoine Young.
It had been deflected, and then Gibbs just with that incredible nose for the basketball around the cylinder. In traffic, there's Carmichael where you want it. Beautiful find by Anthony Cousin, and it's 56-55.
Yeah, the dribble drive that time drew in Echenique, and what you do, you follow right behind the guy defensively and set up shop. Nice, smart play by Carmichael.
McDermott off the curl. Count it.
The 12th lead change of the afternoon.
He's not going to post up Wilkins, although you might want to force him into fouling a little bit, but the beautiful curl and jump shot all in rhythm. He has got a beautiful stroke.
Brown from downtown. Off the back iron. Saved out to Cousin.
Another long rebound for Illinois State.
Nick Moore fills it up. Back and forth we go with an NCAA tournament automatic bid at stake. McDermott left wide open.
Is that any good? Is that any good?
Six lead changes in the last 2 minutes. And McDermott absolutely on fire.
Post up, threes, can do whatever he wants.
31 points for him.
That's a foul, a push on Menega. Illinois State's ability to dribble drive and then create openings is pretty outstanding.
Whether they win this game or not, have they been properly fit for the month of March? They have been. But those are size 22s right there.
Creighton led by Doug McDermott. Look at that, 19 in this half. He scored 17 of the last 19 points in our game to give Creighton this 2-point lead that they have. Very special family. There's his mother, Teresa, a breast cancer survivor. Daughter, Sydney, that's his sister right there. And his younger brother, Nick, is also on hand. And they've got to be so proud of their brother and his son. Look at that. Just an incredible half.
Well, this is when an All-American steps up and takes over in the most important game of the year so far for them. He's posted him up, showing the nice mid-range game, knocked down three. Sydney's having almost a perfect game, 11 of 15 from the field, 3 of 4 from 3, 6 of 6 from the line, 31 points on 15 shots.
By the way, if you notice, Echenique is wearing pink shoes, 00 for Creighton, and that was from a breast cancer night that they had at Omaha, Nebraska, and he played well in them and decided, I'm just going to wear them the rest of the season. And McDermott told us, he's the biggest guy on our team, no one's going to tell him to take them off. And it's been very effective for him all year long.
Right now for Illinois State, they'll be shooting free throws on fouls for the rest of this game still, and they have two to give down at the other end before Creighton gets in the bonus.
Tyler Brown, 77% at the stripe, had a big day yesterday, as we mentioned, in the semifinal win against top-seeded Wichita State. Was 9 of 19 from the floor in that game. All Missouri Valley newcomer.
That's more balanced scoring. Three guys in double figures for the Redbirds. Only two. One of those has 31, so that helps.
Welcome to March, partner, on CBS. We're tied at 60 with just over 2 minutes left.
And if you had asked Tim Jankovic, you wanted to be a two-minute game, he would have signed up for that in a heartbeat. He's exactly where he wants to be.
On the overplay, Inky tries to save it, but was out of bounds. That kid has been special today.
The good news for him, too, he's only got one personal foul, so he can be a little bit more aggressive right now than Wilkins can.
He had 14 double-figure scoring games, and a year ago he had 52 blocks. So as a freshman, he was just off the charts with a record number of rejections for freshmen.
Ichinike out of the game. Interesting matchup now with Carmichael guarding McDermott down in the low post. Let's see if he stays in there or goes out on the perimeter.
Young has it slapped away, and last touch by Ike. Four on the shot clock. You see the timeouts remaining. Creighton with a complement of four. Illinois State can stop it three times. It may take a while for us to reach the conclusion. Ichinike does come back into the game for Ethan Rogge. Tough pass. Now the clock is picking up, but that guy's got it. Off the front iron, and it's run down by Ichinike. He saves it to Young. Beautifully done by Ichinike.
Well, and the most important thing in that situation, you want to make your mistake up on the rim, and McDermott got the ball up there and able to chase down a long rebound.
Ichinike anticipated long rebound from the long shot, and he anticipated properly. Off the high pick, Young feeds Gibbs alone for the tray.
Big time shot. I thought Young had been too aggressive looking for his own ball. That time he set up Gibbs with the jumper.
Gibbs played the role of Steve Kerr there. Everyone's looking for McDermott, and instead it's the complimentary guy that shoots the dagger from downtown. Moore in traffic, and he's fouled by Young. Grant Gibbs had his moment, and Young found him.
This is a terrific find. Just knowing where your shooters are, and he shot that with confidence. 32% on the year.
Wasn't that about the same spot on the floor? We remember Steve Kerr being for big shots at the next level, as well as at Arizona. Huge free throws here for Nick Moore. Can cut it to one here. Runner up for Mr. Indiana basketball a season ago at Warsaw High School. He and Josh Jones having a little conversation, loving this moment. Who is it? The NCAA tournament awaits the winner of this one. You look at our game reset. The possession arrow is to Creighton in a loose ball situation. We've punched the tickets for three teams already in the NCAA tournament field. This will be the fourth in the next 65 seconds to be determined. There are the three teams: Belmont from the Atlantic Sun, Murray State from the Ohio Valley, and UNC Asheville gets it done again for Eddie Beadenbaugh. Who will join them? McDermott will trigger it in with Antoine Young, Grant Gibbs, Josh Jones, and Gregory Ichinike. The five on the deck for Creighton. And a reach-in foul given against Young, committed by Brian Allen.
On par, again, you've got a couple fouls to give, so I think the instructions coming out of the huddle were to let the play develop, see where they were going, and then wrap a guy up.
Yep, extend the game. That's what Tim Jankovic has in mind. And don't let number three hit you again from downtown. He's already got 31 for the afternoon. On the switch, Carmichael is now dealing with McDermott. He takes it inside, and Icky set up. That's going to be a block. Mike Stewart spots it, and I think Icky was in position to pick up the charge, but the foul went against Carmichael prior to the charge being committed. Tough break for Jankovic's team.
Well, and it was McDermott really who drew that foul off the dribble, and it's a smart play.
Watch this. See, I think it was the reach into Carmichael that got whistled. Icky was in position. Tough break for the Redbirds. Coming up next, an opportunity for Michigan State to claim the Big Ten title outright. Ohio State in a position to claim a tie for the regular season. And Michigan figures into that equation. So that is the finale of our triple hitter today on CBS. If you look at our game reset and fouls to give are being used up now by Illinois State, you do see they do have one timeout remaining.
And Creighton's very positioned well right here.
The next foul, there will be shooting.
Right, and a full complement of timeouts as well. So if they can't get the ball in, that's not an issue.
Shot clock is off.
This is your guy, 89% free throw shooting.
Nanaga being checked by Moore. And a quick timeout given. 23.2 left. Greg McDermott wants to talk about it. Take it.
This isn't about revenge.
We are back. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski. Tim Jankovic's club did not foul as quickly as you thought they might have in that last sequence.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting, but they, you know, the Creighton did a terrific job getting it to their 89% free throw shooter and letting him dribble the ball out. And then again, having those timeouts in your back pocket, he was in a bad way. He picked up his dribble, was able to, you know, get the ball over to the sideline.
Yeah, Jaheim's Managa is that 89% free throw shooter you were speaking of, and he was not going to let go of the ball. And then ultimately, it was Greg McDermott that called the timeout off of the pressure that was brought by Nick Moore. Gibbs looking to get it in, does so to Antoine Young, and they quickly foul him. Brian Allen picks it up.
And then again, 74 right there, so they've got three guys over 74% that you can get the ball to in that situation.
And with 22 ticks remaining, you see Josh Jones re-entering the game, some defensive for offensive substitutions being made. Achanike also clocking in. Young at the line is one of four today, and I think that's important.
Well, and if you know, throw that out the window now with 22 seconds, but if you're Illinois State, remember it's a 1-1. You got to block out on the first one.
This will make it a three-point game, but still one possession. And a three ball could tie it, and Illinois State also could get a quick one and extend the game with a quick foul if they choose to go inside. Only one of two. They could tie it or win it on this possession. All the way to the rack. Brown does tie it at 64, 15.7 remaining.
I think it's McDermott time.
Gibbs is fouled by Moore. A bump.
Not something that Tim Jankovic wanted.
No, he did not. Brown and Moore were converging.
But see, Tim, that's what I love the play on that situation. It was a poor defensive play by Crane. They scored too quickly, but they got it right back in. No timeouts, put a lot of pressure on Illinois State.
Well, here we go again. With Gibbs at the line. Same scenario, only a three ball could still win it, and you only need the two to tie. Timeout, Creighton. A Missouri Valley Conference tournament title. An at-large for Creighton to secure, but an automatic maybe for Southern Illinois when we come back. You remember that Butler team of a year ago that decided to drive to the basket, put it on the rim with about 4 or 5 seconds left, and then let the bigs go get it, Matt Howard? Well, yesterday in a similar position, Tim Jankovic decided to clear out and let Tyler Brown take it.
Well, and I think you're going to see a similar situation now. Definitely, that was in the half court yesterday. This is in a full court with 11.8, plenty of time to get it up. But let your guy go to work in the middle and get a shot up with enough time to give yourself a chance to get an offensive rebound.
Moore and Allen are in the backcourt along with Brown. Icky, who is a dangerous three-ball shooter. Carmichael is out, so it's really a very small lineup shy of Ikey on the floor.
You know what I do, too? And I'm all for putting pressure on him. Go for the win here. Go for the three.
Why not?
I think the longer the game goes, the more in favor it is of Creighton.
Nick Moore, the fantastic freshman from Indiana, all the way to the rack. We're tied at 66. He challenged Grant Gibbs. He took it with willpower right to the rack to tie it up.
Boy, what a great find down the other end. And they just, he really had Youngin full reverse all the way. What a great shot.
Oh. Just over 6 seconds left. We may have more in St. Louis. 6 seconds left. Now I think the world knows that McDermott is your first option, but it's not as if there aren't other guys that can stick it. We've seen that from Grant Gibbs already, Mike.
Yeah, and you're going to wonder right now if they're going to put the ball in McDermott's hands and let him bring it full court, or if Antoine Young is going to be involved.
Did you question Illinois State taking a shot that quickly?
Well, it's just, no, I mean, you got to take the score. And,
right.
I mean, and he Moore made a terrific play. You know, you leave the door open here, but you have to, first things first, tie
Absolutely.
The game up.
Absolutely. Gibbs will trigger it in for Antoine Young. As Shanike is in the game, and he's resting up around the top where you'd normally think a pick would be set by the big guy to help free the guard for a big-time shot. Antoine Young with the clock winding down all the way to the rack. And Shanike, no! We will go to overtime with a tournament bid at stake for upstart Illinois State. You ready for five more, my friend? Let's go, huh? Oh, the iron unkind to Creighton. And we'll go an extra session in St. Louis. It has been said, Mike Jeminski, that college basketball has become a tournament game in recent years. I would submit to you that college basketball and basketball in general has always been a tournament game. From the time you were in middle school, high school on, it was about surviving and advancing. And this Illinois State team embodies all that tradition and history is about.
No question about it. And they've done a terrific job staying in this game. A lower scoring game really benefited them. They've defended very well. Just wonder right now, at what point is yesterday's relatively easy win going to help Creighton as far as their legs are? Do they have more energy right now than the Redbirds?
As we begin the overtime, Wilkins sits, and the reason for that is number 13 for Illinois State is the only participant with four fouls. The opening tap control to Creighton. Each team gets the additional timeout, and we're underway in overtime. Six lead changes in the last 4 minutes and 50 seconds of regulation, and Gibbs opens with another triple.
They needed another guy to step up, and Grant Gibbs has been that guy. He's been terrific in the last 5 minutes of the game, and that was an excellent find by McDermott.
On the overplay, Gibbs nearly created a deflection.
See, they're kind of cheating on that double team, but boy, he just got lost. You want to make a nice cross-court pass and beat the defense.
And another example of the total player that McDermott is, Mike. His ability to read defenses and make great passes, even when he doesn't score, is tremendous. Cousin, the pull-up. Goes crying off the iron, and it's 69-66. Antoine Young leading the way for Creighton. He's been steady in the backcourt. Jones dumps it down to McDermott. Nice spin move, and he's rejected by Ikey.
Terrific defense that time.
Nick Moore, who made the bucket to tie it.
Now too early in the shot clock. A little bit of a rush right there. Nerves starting to creep in a little bit.
Just a freshman, as we mentioned, from Indiana. But he has been the fire plug for this club. They wouldn't be where they are without him. Yeah.
tough shooting night for Young. 2 of 8 now in the game.
70.
Critical possession right now for Illinois State.
71-66. Boy, Brown is wide open, but Moore decides to take it again right to the rim, and he's fouled. It will go against Echenique.
Now you get your fortune at the miss right there. It goes over. Ike had done a nice job positioning himself, but just a very fortunate rebound for Creighton.
Wilkins will check in now for Ike. And a reminder, Ohio State and Michigan State are underway, and we'll be taking you directly to that Big Ten battle for the regular season crown as soon as we're done here in St. Louis with the Missouri Valley Conference Championship game. Freshman point with over 100 assists in his freshman year since Victor Williams did it 14 years ago in Normal, Illinois. 71-68. Wilkins trying to stay with McDermott and doing so with 4 fouls. Young with the shot clock under 10, a scoop to the hoop.
And Echenique made that possible, too. A little screen for him inside. I thought that's the best shot that he's taken in the last 10 minutes.
Brown in traffic, can't get it to go. Echenique retrieves it. Redbirds really need a stop here. We mentioned it, Mike. You wondered, because of the challenges of yesterday's win against Wichita State, when would their legs begin to fail them? Illinois State down 5 and really in need of a stop. Gibbs all the way to the rack.
It's just been too easy off the dribble in the last 2 possessions.
Moore again. And he's fouled as he takes it inside. He has been very effective with his quickness and at the very least getting to the free throw line.
4th personal foul for Echenique.
Yep. For those of you that are interested in checking out the Ohio State-Michigan State game immediately, it's available live on CBSSports.com, and we'll be joining them immediately at the conclusion of our game. Illinois State 0 for 3 from the floor in the overtime. Jankovic looking to get Anthony Cousin in after this free throw. He will replace Brian Allen. Still a 5-point deficit for Illinois State to deal with.
How about for Moore? 17 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds.
And the pressure forces Creighton to call a timeout.
And that was on Tom Gibbs. He knew he should have gotten the ball in.
1:43 remaining with an NCAA tournament bid at stake. We should touch on what's at stake from Creighton's perspective. We know Illinois State, Mike, has to win to get in. But this is a Blue Jays team that was off to just a tremendous start at the beginning of the year in their first 23 games. And then they hit a bit of a skid and rebounded. But if they were to win the conference championship, I'm guessing they could move up as high as, what, 5?
Yeah, 6 or 5. I don't think that they could get to where Wichita State was. And
right.
Then you were talking about them as a 4 seed, which I don't think will happen now. They're going to slip a little bit, but I don't think that Creighton can get to that level.
I would agree with you. And Illinois State is just trying to win their way into the dance. Gibbs pressured in the backcourt. Quickly trapped. And they got a tie ball. Well, did they get a foul or no? Wait a minute. I think we may have an overrule here.
Oh, they got a timeout before the foul was called.
And you know what? A good piece of officiating by Scott Thornley to get that. He identified before the foul that a timeout
had been taken. I don't think it was a foul. It might have been a tied up ball. Yeah, it would have been an ISU's ball.
I think that's what Jankovic is saying. It was a tie ball rather than a foul. So another break for Creighton here in the overtime period.
Okay, look, when gas prices jump, you still gotta work. So suddenly you're cutting back on everything from family vacations to cell phone minutes. Well, here's a thought. How about cutting back on gas? Here's how. The Ford F-150. It gets 23 highway miles per gallon. That's the best. So you can get the job done and get a break at the pump. Yeah, how's that sound? This is the future. This is the Ford F-150.
Tim Jankovic has been here many times before at a club that had an outstanding shot at winning the tournament title, only to fall to Northern Iowa before they went on an incredible run just a few years ago.
And think about this, Tim. Last year, this Illinois State team, 12-19, 4-14 in conference, and here they are in the championship game 1 year later.
Amazing. 75-70, a minute 34 remaining. Wilkins is in there checking McDermott, and as we mentioned, he is playing with four.
That's the one thing I really hate that rule about college basketball. You can throw it into the backcourt in that situation. I just think it penalizes the defense. Got to be able to get it. You can only use half the court.
Antoine Young will get to the line. I agree with you, and I don't know why they're taking so much time. It's not so bad to say that the other league has a better idea. Go ahead, change it. You know? They did that with the restraining area underneath the hoop this past year, and really it took a while for that to be implemented.
Right.
Young, 2 out of 6 at the line. It's his third free throw today, and it's now a two-possession game at 76-70. Look at that. That's the most points since 07 in a Missouri Valley Conference game.
Kind of fitting he's got 33. Some guy, pretty good guy wore number 33.
Yeah, I think he won the award named after him. Brown from downtown, not there. And Illinois State running out of gas.
It just seemed that as the longer this game went, the more it would favor Creighton.
Yeah, you thought they should have taken the three at the end of regulation. You did. Moore, a little floater that doesn't go. Ikey sets up for three. That shot looked like one of fatigue. Coming off the front iron, out of bounds. Last touched by Illinois State. And the Creighton coronation may be about to begin. And a lot of sighs of relief around the bubble of the power conferences in this country. Illinois State 0-for-6 in the overtime. Again, the pressure leads to a turnover.
They've caught themselves. They've dribbled into that corner over the half court line.
And Carmichael hits the three. So Jackie Carmichael, who's only hit one other three ball this season, hits his second in four tries. It's still a two-possession game. Just when you thought you were going to be able to wrap this one up in a nice, pretty bow, a horrible turnover committed by Creighton gives Illinois State life.
And they have not handled that pressure well, just dribbling right over half court into the trap. And it's a two-possession game right now with plenty of time left, so let's hold off on the court and take care of business here.
Well, with the shot-blocking capability Illinois State has, there's always an opportunity. Boy, that was a near steal. Brown just missed that pass into Antoine Young, and the foul committed by Nick Moore. Again, a reminder, the Big Ten regular season title is at stake in our third and final game of the afternoon on CBS. We'll be getting you out there immediately after our game concludes. East Lansing or Michigan State and Ohio State are already underway. And for those of you that need to get there immediately, it's being broadcast now on CBSSports.com. You can go there immediately and find it. We'll switch everyone over there soon. Sparty has the early lead in that game. 81-73. Moore pumps from downtown and gets it to go. No timeouts remaining. So they must foul and extend this game.
You talked about it early on that Young had trouble at the free throw line, but seems to have gotten himself back in a rhythm. He's been solid.
Yep, he had missed. He was 2 out of 5 before he got to the free throw line before. By the way, Nick Moore, you talk about the future of this program at Illinois State, where it is. It's in great hands. That kid, only a freshman, one of the great recruiting stories for a school the size of Illinois State, a 3-star recruit. As we mentioned, a runner-up for Mr. Basketball in the state of Indiana. 20 points today, 5 assists. Little stop and go by Cousin, feeds Moore from downtown. Not there. Carmichael the rebound. Icky pumps from three. He gets it to go. 82-79. 10.9 remaining.
One possession.
The Redbirds won't go away. And the foul committed by Cousin. They just want to extend this game as long as they possibly can.
Unbelievable resolve by Illinois State. Look at this. This is good. Let him play inside. A referee staying off the whistle. And that was a big-time shot, the separation with the one dribble for Icky.
3 trays in 27 seconds after absolutely nothing the first 4 minutes of this overtime period for Illinois State. Again, 1 out of 2, but they have to score in a hurry. Brown for three. Was looking to induce the foul, couldn't, and the Creighton Blue Jays are champions of the Missouri Valley Conference.
Well, terrific job by Creighton, and congratulations to Greg McDermott and the Blue Jays. They are the fourth team that we can say are officially in the dance.
And for Tim Jankovic of the Redbirds of Illinois State, job well done. And in that other postseason tournament, they're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Well, and they gave a terrific win against Wichita State, their first time being a ranked opponent in 20 tries, and then giving Creighton all they wanted in this final.
Grant Gibbs and McDermott combined for 53 of their 83 points. For Mike Jaminski, Tim Brando saying so long from St. Louis. Next on CBS, Ohio State and Michigan State. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports. We crowned a champion today on the road to the Final Four.